my trials for your glory. The hardships of the present, they never bring joy, but pain and sorrow. Ask any man, woman, girl, or boy. There will be thorns amid life's flowers, you know. We come across them everywhere we go. Take Job, for instance. Everything was going well. He had animals, possessions, treasures too numerous to tell, until all was taken away. Then the boils, no rest. His allegiance to God was the ultimate test. And Noah had to face the doubtful residents who saw him building the ark, yet wanted more evidence that rain will fall from the heavens from up high. God vindicated him when great drops of water fell from the sky. Daniel had a few trials as well to report then, of the king's meat, fiery furnace, and the lion's den. The dreams God helped him understand, interpret, and tell, all these show the mighty power of God as well. We too can find no bliss that is not mixed with pain. As we go through life's sunshine and the rain, the trials will come. Yes, they are expected, as those who would live godly in Christ will be afflicted. In the classroom, at work, or on the playfield, the exam, project, or game can surely yield a bad experience when the devil steps in. Our response to these trials, God can help us to win. Even at home, relationships we must bear. Brothers and sisters, parents and children tear at each other. Family conflicts are rife, even those among spouses, husband versus wife. In the church too, conflicts may also arise. The pressures to be godly, some are under disguise, for they act one way when they are on the street, and another way when at church you then meet. As to our dress, conduct, and the things we wear, the world and the Christian look the same, I hear. When we are told to be temperate in all things, few examples for the youth, church folk wearing makeup and earrings. For some, money is their trial, their test. Can't seem to keep much of it in the pocket to rest, for they spend it all, no tithe and offering to give. Without God, wallets, purses, and banks become sieves. Others struggle with their identity and sexuality. The world has distorted gender, male and female it should be. Society wants the world to accept these new rules. All these are but part of the devil's destructive tools. The use of the internet, social media, and smartphones, including sexting, cyberbullying, catfishing, and porn, are trials many a young person these days face. Older adults are also subject to this evil in cyberspace. But thanks be to God for His marvelous grace, where we as struggling sinners can seek His face, to ask for His help to get us through these trials and troubles, our strength to renew. That when we are able to trust the Master's plan, others around us will then be able to understand how we overcame our deepest, darkest point, because the blood of Jesus Christ did anoint. We can then tell others, yes, to testify about God's goodness, His name to glorify, for only He alone can transform our life story. Yes, my trials, your trials are for His glory.